This is Jerry from Destination China. Here we are at the Great Wall of Juyong Pass section. The Great Wall symbolizes China's ancient civilization. It's one of the ancient construction wonders in the world. For many centuries, the Great Wall as a military defensive project to keep away the invading troops of northern nomadic tribes such as Hans and Mongolians. You know, in the ancient time, there was no modern means for transportation. The building materials just carried by the back-breaking laborers, soldiers, slaves, even the animals. So lots of people died when they built the Great Wall. So it's also called the longest cemetery in the world. Originally, the Great Wall was constructed during the spring and autumn Wen States period of 7th century BC. At that time, different kingdoms constantly fought against each other to further their own interests. During the wars, in order to prevent attacks by other kingdoms, they built high and strong walls between their respective beacon towers. And there were three peaks of construction of the Great Wall. The first time, in the Qin Dynasty, in 221 BC, Qin Shi Huang unified China at that time. He established a centralized feudal country for the stable development of the feudal economy. And Qin Shi Huang ordered to link up all the separate walls and extend it to the Great Wall with a total length about 5,000 kilometers. And the second time was carried in the Han Dynasty, and the wall of the Han Dynasty altogether 10,000 kilometers. And the last peak of construction of the Great Wall was carried in the Ming Dynasty, from 1368 to 1644. And on the Great Wall, we can see two different kinds of towers. One is called Watchtower. Generally speaking, watchtowers are two or three stories high. There are four windows on each side of the outer walls of the watchtowers. And watchtowers can be directly used to shoot at enemies who are climbing up the mountain, and they can also be used to store weapons. And another tower is called the Beacon Tower. A beacon tower was also known as a pile of fire, beacon fire, or wolf dung tower. Beacon towers are usually built on the summit of the mountains or at the turn of the mountains. Most beacon towers are independent structures, separate from the Great Wall. Beacon towers were used for sending out military information. During the day, the smoke could be sent from afar. The fire itself could be seen during the night. And there are several venues could be rented at this section of the Great Wall for the private events, either during the daytime or at night. And at night, all the lights up along the Great Wall. It feels like a huge dragon traverse on the mountain. What a life experience. Even in winter time, the heaters and crystal marquees would be prepared.